just beautiful. The way he makes us believe is just beautiful. And when it comes to magic, Jason Bird is less about smoke and mirrors and more into telling stories. And he's bringing it all to a new show to Vegas this weekend. Here with more, please welcome the man himself, Jason Bird. Thank you so much for joining us.
Well, thank you so much for having me.
So bringing this show, Fable, to Las Vegas, I love the name because it's not so much a fantasy because there always is a story behind it.
Exactly.
Yeah, so tell me more about the show.
So the show is kind of two parts. It's me creating kind of like this other world.
Uh-huh.
And these are where all the stories are.
I love that.
So it really highlights the connections between people. And then the second part of it is interacting in that world with the audience. So there's a lot of things that the audience gets to do in this show.
Ooh,
so,
I like that.
Contributing, and then there's even a trick where everybody in the whole audience does it together. So
see, those are the ones that get me.
Yeah.
When you can fool the whole audience, that's when I'm like, this is real. He really did something, because how can all of us have not seen what just happened.
It's a very special moment in the show,
And I understand that you actually imagined this show when you were a teenager.
Yeah, it's like one of those things where you just kind of get an idea in your head of doing this magic show that had an overarching story for the whole thing. And it's taken me a long time to kind of put pieces of it together. So
yeah, because this isn't your first rodeo. You've definitely been on some big shows.
Yeah.
Like you're a big name in the magic world.
Yeah.
That's really cool that you kind of finally get to hone in on that dream. Now, talk to me a little bit more about the stories. Because, you know, a lot of times magicians, it's like just big puffs of clouds. And you're really getting, you're inspiring us.
That's, and inspiring is one of the great best words for it, because that's really what I'm trying to do. And so it's kind of taking the meaningful part of magic and kind of re-injecting it back into it. So it is about the relationships and the story on stage.
I love that. I love the butterfly that you're doing there with the dollar bill.
Yeah.
That is so cool.
Yeah.
Now, you are holding some cards.
I'm
assuming you're
going
to do a trick for me.
Yeah, I wanted to show you something.
Okay.
So this most people think that magicians need all 52 cards to fool people, but that's not true.
Okay.
This one's only two cards.
There's a queen
and a nine. Just remember, red card and a black card. Okay. Have you ever seen the guys that do the three card Monty where they move the cards around?
Really
you have to
fast. Really
guess
fast.
Where the queen is, right?
Okay.
So if I take the queen and put it over here, and you bet money on where you think the queen is, where you think the queen is.
It's going to be right there.
The queen's actually over here. It's over here in the hand.
Oh, my goodness.
I'll give you another chance. Queen over here again.
Money,
double or nothing?
Just saw you.
What do you think? Double or nothing?
Well, I don't know. I know better than to bet on that, but if I had to, I'd say
you'd lose money again.
You.
Yeah, that's because that card's over there.
Oh my gosh.
You want to learn this one? This one's pretty easy.
You'll teach it?
I'll teach this to you.
Okay.
Yeah. All right, so here is the big secret. There's one card that has a double face. I know. And one card is a double back.
What?
Yeah.
Okay.
So when you show them, you're going to show them this, and then when you turn your hand over, you just switch
people
the position of the cards, and your brain fills in the gap, and so you're playing with it.
Yeah, so
you do it. So
you do like
take
this?
It. Yep. And then when you turn it over, you say, "There's a queen there, and I also have a nine here." So now you just take out the nine, or take out the queen, whichever way you want to do it, and put that behind your back.
So I'm gonna say, "Oh, the queen is
right
here."
Yep. So you're gonna put the queen behind your back, and now bet money, and people say, "Oh, the queen's behind your back." Now all you do is turn it over and bring. There you go. And then you have to put the cards together when you want to show the other one. So put it here, and then, you can't do that. You put them together and then you flip them over. It's your first time. Literally your first time.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah, that's for you. That's a gift.
You're giving away your secrets, man.
I know. This one's okay. This one I'll be cool.
That's fun, though. That's really fun.
Yeah.
Thanks for sharing us.
Yeah, of course.
Now, talk to me a little bit about growing up in Wisconsin. I'm a Midwestern girl, too.
Oh, really?
It's got to be a lot to get from Wisconsin to get up on a stage.
It is a lot. It is a lot. My hometown in Wisconsin is 1,600 people.
Uh-huh.
That was my little tiny.
That's like my high school.
Yeah, that's like my little town. So when I turned 18 and said, "Mom, Dad, I'm going to Vegas," because that's where all the magicians live.
Yeah.
And I've been here ever since.
Wow, there's one of my favorite stories that I watch when you do what do you call this one?
That one's Mr. Kindness.
The Mr. Kindness, right.
Yeah.
The homeless bird lady.
That's probably my favorite thing that I do.
Yeah, it is so beautiful, guys. You got to bring the whole family to the Rampart Casino on Sunday. The show is called Fable. It starts at 3 p.m. Tickets to see Jason Bird just start at $18. Go to rampartcasino.com for more. I'm next because I got the tricks down.
That's it. You're going to open for me.
Right?